Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. My channel name is Woman in Tech. So today guys, I'm going to show you what exactly, like how to calculate AUC ROC curve in machine learning. So for that, first we have to see what is AUC ROC curve. So basically, this is an AUC ROC band. Is basically it is a representation estimation for grouping issues at different limit settings. So ROC is like a likelihood band, and AUC speaks to degree or proportion of distinctions. It basically tells how much model is fed for recognizing classes. Higher the AUC, better the model is at forcing zeros and ones as ones. So by similarly, higher the AUC, the better the model is at recognizing patients with sickness and no infections. So basically in this, what we will going to find out is we will find out is the first one is the true positive rate, which is TPR. So for TPR, we have to calculate TPR. The formula will be TP, which is a true positive, divided by true positive plus false negative. And another thing which we have to calculate is the false positive rate, which is FPR. So for FPR, we have to calculate, which is the formula will be false positive FP divided by FP, which is false positive, plus TN, which is true negative. So let's begin. So this will be the library functions which I was using: import numpy as np, pandas as pd, matplotlibrary.pyplot as plt. This library function I'm using to basically to plot the curve. Import seaborn as sns. Then after that library function, I am using the data set. So the data set which I am using, which is kdd.underscore dataset.csv, basically I have used this, I have downloaded this data set from the internet. I think I got this data set from Kaggle. I will drop a link under my video, so you can also download this data set. And after that, I was using this library function, and then x is equal to dataset.iloc. So basically in this, after that, from sklearn.preprocessing import preimputer, and after all these coding, np.saved missing values, I am also finding missing data removed. But this is like from sklearn.preprocessing import label encoder, one hot encoder. This is basically this is all code which I will be writing. So in that, from now onwards, I will basically like splitting the data set into the training set and test set for linear. So here I'm like splitting the data set. Here you can see from sklearn, I've just split the data set into training set and test set for linear. Okay. And after that, I'm just like importing all the machine learning algorithms which I am using. Like the first one I am using is K-Neighbor Classifier, Gaussian NB, Random Forest Classifier, Decision Tree Classifier, SVC, SVM. So yeah, so here I am like importing all those machine learning algorithms, importing train, test plate, ROC curve, AUC, ROC, AUC score. So after that, I've used my first library machine learning algorithm, which is a random forest. So for that, this is the random to use a random forest in machine learning. This is like the code which we have to use, like rf is equal to random forest classifier and underscore estimators is equal to 5. And after that, I'm using k nearest neighbor, same like that. And after that, Gaussian NB. Then decision tree classifier, SVM, support vector machine. So matlab you can use like multiple machine learning algorithms, like same I'm using, like only just like the extension or the library function is changing, baki all the things will remain the same. After that, what I'm going to do is I'm basically like predicting the probabilities. So for predicting the probabilities, I have written this code. Same like this. Okay. So for that, and after that predicting the probabilities, I'm basically calculating the AUROC. So for calculating the AUROC, simply I write the code RF underscore AUC. RF is basically the random forest, ROC underscore AUC underscore score, which I have to calculate. Y underscore test, we basically like to split the training set earlier. RF underscore probes, it's basically predicting the probabilities. So same I have done with every machine, each individual machine learning. NB is the no, NB Gaussian, Naive Bayes, DC, same like DC, same like SVM. For SVM, the library we used is SVC, KN for K nearest neighbor. After that, what we are going to do is we basically like printing the random forest AURC values, and after that we'll just getting these values. Random forest AURC is equal to 1, Naive Bayes AUROC 0.944, decision tree we are getting 0.980, support vector machine we are getting 0.957, KNN AURC is we are getting the value which is 0.996. So only random forest we are getting AUROC is equal to 1.0 approx 1. So basically, yeah, this is the best value, a yeah, good value, we can say that. So after that we are predicting the test set results. For the test set results, like this, for each machine learning we are doing individually, like RF, same as like random forest underscore FPR, RFTPR, ROC curve, Y underscore test, RF probes. After that, what we are going to do is we are going to plot ROC curve. For that, I have written each code for an individual machine learning. And for that, we are just basically plot the AUROC curve. So for that, we need an X label, we need false positive rate. Y label, we need true positive rate. And the title, which is the receiver operating characteristics, ROC curve, plot.legend, plot.show. Okay, so now we will going to like plot dot underscore underscore curve, RF underscore FPR, RF underscore TPR. So for that, we got this curve. This is in receiver operating characteristics, ROC curve, and the values which are getting, which is AUROC curve. Let me just zoom it. So after zooming it, you can see the only random forest, the value which I'm getting AUROC, maximum AUROC value, which is 1, which is of random forest, blue line. And in the X label, we are getting false positive rate. And in the Y label, we are getting true positive rate. So the ROC curve is basically plotted with TPR. I told you earlier, TPR, true positive rate, against the FPR, false positive rate. Okay, so where TPR is the true positive rate is on the y-axis, and FPR is on the x-axis. So basically, after all this code and after all this like results, we get this curve, which is a receiver operating curve. So basically, this curve is showing the comparison between the algorithms which we used. So basically, we use like some of algorithms like random forest, k nearest neighbor, naive Bayes, decision tree, support vector machine. So basically, it is showing that the random forest this gives better classification, and it's also it trains fast as compared to other algorithms. Okay, so after the result, we are getting the random forest is getting, it's like gives better classification, and also it trains fast as compared to other algorithms like Naive Bayes, decision tree, support vector machine, KNN. So that's all. Thank you.